And we'll also hear from Aaron Andrews in a bit. This presentation of College Football is brought to you by Spark, who reminds you that what you can measure, you can improve. Today's game is between Louisiana Monroe Warhawks and the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers. Through this incredible season, and we've got what looks to be an exciting game coming up. It's time for the coin toss, presented by Spark, who reminds you that what you can measure, you can improve. Western Kentucky has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
Let's take a look at some action in the ACC. And for Boston College, they've lost two in a row.
All right, thanks, Reese. For UL Monroe. And Kirk, what do we think we're going to see here?
Well, they use a spread look. A lot of teams tend to throw more out of it because you've got a bunch of receivers out there. But I think it can be really effective for running the football, too. You can go with some options or even some designed runs. There's definitely room for it. Really good job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 22. Zips it to the tight end. Brought down at the 28-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he can't get away from the pressure.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Baldwin is waiting for the snap. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. They'll set up shop at the 49. First and 10.
Designed play that time to give him a first down. Linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
From the 38-yard line, first down. Keep it on the ground again. Knocked out of bounds around the 29-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. from the 29-yard line. It's second down.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage.
Gets a block on the corner.
He's at the 20. And he's all the way in for the touchdown.
And that carry puts him over the 1,000-yard mark for rushing this season.
Just staying healthy an entire year should be considered success for a running back. There is no doubt that this guy has been a large part of his team's success.
Western Kentucky is up by 6. And he converts the extra point. A short two-play, 38-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The score now, 7-0. Western Kentucky is lined up. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Back to pass. He's out of bounds around the 26-yard line. That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up 2nd and 9. They'll change the play at the line of scrimmage. Barnes steps back to pass. And down he goes at the 33-yard line.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Third down and short, and the stadium is rocking right now. He may have changed things up here. Nice run there.
Very effective play calling in a third down situation. It's plays like that you need to win ball games. Convert on third down.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Fires in a hurry. Interception. And he's taken down at about the 49. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Western Kentucky is up a score. They go with the back, and he's got room. Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
From the 36-yard line, it's first down. It's the tailback, and he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
So it's 2nd down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Tosses it out. He's at the 20. Now it's 1st and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game.
They've got a solid drive going here. And I know it's not going to mean that much without putting some points up on the board.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. fights forward to about the 7. That brings up a 2nd and goal. 7 yards for the touchdown. Western Kentucky is up 7.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
It's 3rd down, and they come up to the line about 9 yards away from the end zone. They're going to pitch it. He's taken down to the 9-yard line.
Once he saw it was a run, he made a great break on the ball and used his speed to make the big tackle.
It's 4th down. They're going to go for the easy 3 here. Western Kentucky is hoping to make this a 2-score game. He gets it up, and he hooked it left. Well, they leave 3 points on the field there.
When you miss a field goal at this short of range, you're giving away points. You're also giving a huge boost to the other team. And I don't know which one hurts more.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Receiver screen and complete. Second and 10. Ball on the 20. They bring the quarterback down.
You know, I don't think the offense did a very good job of recognizing the corner blitz. The quarterback's got to do a better job of using his eyes to recognize the blitz, and also it would have helped if the wide receiver would have been pointing like crazy at the corner, letting the quarterback know, hey, we've got a blitz here. That's time is a big-time miscommunication by the offense.
So the sack makes this 3rd and very long. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Drops back to pass. He airs it out. And he got it! Tackle made around the 42-yard line.
Brings him down at the 42-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts.
Think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
From the 42-yard line, 2nd down. Hit and still completed it. Now, Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
It's absolutely deafening down there. Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. Powers. Options out to the left. That's not going to keep the drive going.
Good, solid defense there to force them into a 4th down situation.
Play is back deep to return.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
They missed a chance at 3 points on their last drive.
Anytime you have a shot at putting points on the board and you don't get it, You get a little frustrated, but this offense is very capable of scoring at any time.
He's still going. He's to the 20. Gains his way to the 26-yard line, making 100 yards rushing for him.
The game plan they devised has been working fantastically, and nowhere has that been more evident than in the rushing numbers.
From their own 26-yard line, first down. Western Kentucky is up by a touchdown. Hand off to the right. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And they finally tackle him at the 48-yard line.
I thought it was pretty impressive they were able to stop him. I thought he had enough room to break away from everybody and take it all the way to the house.
From the 48-yard line, first down. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's at the 30. Big gain there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big gain.
From the 18-yard line, it's first down. They're back in the red zone where they have really struggled lately. The handoff on the counter, inside the 10. And he's tackled around the 4-yard line. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
An update on the game at University Park. And for Ohio State, they're sleepwalking through this thing. If they don't turn it around, they're going to get into a world of trouble. And for Johnson, he's caught one for a touchdown.
Well, you can never look ahead a week, but that would be a pretty big upset if that score holds. First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. Western Kentucky up 7 points. He'll get it again. That gives him another touchdown to go along with the one he scored earlier.
This guy has great vision out of the backfield. Even if a hole isn't there, he's patient enough to wait for one to open, and then he hits it.
He makes the PAT. As we expected coming into this game, this one appears to be under control. The Hilltoppers lead it by 2 touchdowns. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Wilson deep to return. He boots it deep downfield. He's to the 10. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. They'll start this drive at the 21-yard line. Bring him down in the backfield. It's second down, 15 to go.
Ball on the 16-yard line. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Third down. And as they come up to the line, they're going to be in the shadow of their own goalpost. And this stadium is alive. He drops back. And a quick throw. And he hits him hard at the 15-yard line. The offense didn't appear to be in sync on that series.
Very nicely done here by the defense. They did a good job of keeping them in check on their side of the field.
Baldwin awaits the snap. Tackle made at the 46-yard line. They'll set up shop at the 46. And he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. Here's the halfback. He's at the 30. Tackle at the 23.
The halfback was able to do it there with his legs. This misdirection counter threw off the defense, and once this guy got into the open field, he was off to the races.
Looking to capitalize on the big run. Now it's first and 10. Here's the run. Got a hole. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
Sometimes when you've got speed, that's all you need. It's the one thing you just can't defend.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Nice run, and he's brought down. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
We take you out to a battle in the Big Ten. Let's take a look at this one again. The Nittany Lions strike through the air, getting into the end zone for a touchdown. And for Hick, he's tossed a couple of touchdown passes. Penn State's on top, 14-7. Middle of the second quarter.
Well, if that score holds up, that would be water cooler talk on Monday morning. They're at the 6. It's second down. They come out in a goal line set. Room around the corner. Touchdown, Western Kentucky. He's been a force getting to pay dirt three times.
I tell you, these guys are coming out firing on all cylinders. They've really taken control of this game early.
And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 54-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. Miller Dawson ready to kick. Sends it sailing downfield. They'll go to work at the 25-yard line. He's on the run. And he's sacked.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack.
He could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Well, that is great coverage by this defense. They did everything that they could to force that wide receiver into a very small window close to the boundary. The quarterback makes the throw to give his receiver a chance to make a play. The problem is there's no room left for the receiver to get his foot down for the catch.
Play, back to return it. And he just got drilled. Return for a year. This drive will start at the 43-yard line.
Here we go. 395.
Here he goes. He makes his way to about the 42. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is out to drooling about.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Lucky 95! Lucky 95!
They'll work the left side. And they make the stop around the 22-yard line. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. Flares it and almost had it intercepted.
Harrison, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 22-yard line, it's second down. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So it's second down and 15 after the penalty. They're going to pitch it. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
That'll bring up third and long.
From the 28-yard line, it's third down. Get it out there on the toss. Nice run there as they work the outside.
You know, great effort here by the ball carrier, but I think they need to pass in that situation most of the time.
Authority.
Brady's a physical football player, but he's also got the finesse to make a big impact in the passing game.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice six-play, 46-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The score now, 28-0. Western Kentucky to kick this one off.
Miller deep to return.
Taken at the five. And down he goes at the 22. They'll go to work at the 22-yard line. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 87 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Powers steps back to pass, and he's taken down around the 25-yard line.
For a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up third and six.
Trying to change the play. They get to the quarterback, and now the ball is loose. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
Penn State taking the field in University Park. This is a game we've been watching closely today. The Nittany Lions are on top, 17-7.
A 28-0 shutout right now here, Reese.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Baldwin to punt. Played a half of football. Western Kentucky leads 28-0. Set to kick off to start the second half and looking for a closer 30 minutes this time around. And this is just a booming kick. For Western Kentucky, they looked about as solid as any team could, and they cruised to a big halftime lead. Aaron Andrews has more from the sideline.
Well, the coach was very happy to see the kind of output in that half, Brad. But he also knows that coming out here in the third quarter and making a strong statement is important. He doesn't want his team to show the other sideline anything less than an all-out effort. Back up to you, Brad.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Western Kentucky in control. Taken down right around the 26-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. Little handoff. Brought down at the 40. From their own 40-yard line, first down. On the run. Nice gain as he works the right side.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That brings up second and five.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. Pitch play here. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line.
That's good enough for another Western Kentucky first down.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Western Kentucky comes to the line. They got a big advantage in this one. Quick throw. He's at the 20. Knocked out of bounds around the 16-yard line. Perfect time for the play-action pass.
Well, here the defense is looking for the run, and the play-action put him in even a worse position. They just weren't ready for the pass there.
First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 21.
Loss of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 15.
From the 21-yard line, it's 2nd down. Looks like they didn't get the play off quick enough.
Dead ball. Play of game. On the offense.
Looked like they might have been a little bit late getting the play in, and it results in a delay of game. So it's 2nd down and long now after the penalty. They're going to pitch it. And now he's got room to run. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. This offense has been driven by this young man with 4 touchdowns.
We wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
Trying to break a record like a DJ. That's 150 bottles in one night. I get it, bitch, act right. Money don't fold, is it act right.
And he tacks on the extra point. Dawson gets set to kick this one away.
Miller back to return.
Miller takes it at the 4. He's tackled at the 29-yard line.
Well, that's what it's all about for these guys. If you can turn up the pressure, you'll create more chances for your defense.
This is turning into a day that the offensive line wants to forget. All the good plays from this defense has helped them into the lead. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. He's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. He lost the ball. And down he goes at the 36-yard line.
What else is new? These guys have been dominating all day. And now they can add this fumble recovery to their collection of big plays.
Excellent field position to start the drive. Western Kentucky up big right now in this one. They'll give it off here. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That brings up 2nd and 5.
From the 31-yard line, it's 2nd down. They go to the ground, and he's got the first. Tackle at the 14. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese?
Time to get you up to date on what's going on in University Park. Let's take a look at this one again. And for Ohio State, they're having all kinds of trouble so far. And for Hick, he's over the 150-yard mark. Penn State's on top, 17-14.
Reese, we really got a lopsided game here. From the 14-yard line, it's first down. They go with the toss. Here he goes. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
In the club, got them bottles on replay. Trying to break a record like a DJ. That's 150 bottles in one night.
And he hits the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They still have time to put up a few scores. The question is, will it be enough, and can their defense make enough stops for it to matter? Goes incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Wilson, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and ten.
Second and ten. Ball on the 25-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle made right around the 38-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
On the draw play. Nice run there.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Receivers got the first down. And they make the stop at the 45-yard line.
What can you say if you're on this offense? You're already chasing these guys, and now you've got to give them the ball back. Not the way you want to get back into this game.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
He's looking to pass. Tosses across the middle to his tight end. That's a great tackle at the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
Come on, And it looks like they're going to change it up here.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
And he hits him hard at the 36.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He's on the run. Sacked, and they'll turn it over.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
The offense will take over at the 40-yard line. Western Kentucky with a big advantage. Gives it to the back. Decent run here, right side. The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counterplay. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Toss. He's at the 40. And he tackles him hard at the 24.
That's always a big blow to a defense to give up a long run like that. You'll see a lot of those guys hanging their head.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Delta! Delta!
Up the middle. Inside the 10. There's another. Handoff and knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
In the club, got them bottles on replay. Trying to break a record like a DJ. That's 150 bottles in one night.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They'll set up shop at the 25-yard line. Drops to throw on first down. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed him.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 25. Looking to throw. Scrambling around. And he is drilled at the 21-yard line.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
And they'll probably try to throw here as they line up on third down and 14. Looks to pass. Fumble! Defense says they've got it, and they do.
When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, uh-oh, we can't let him get another one so quickly.
He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running backs.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 20-yard line, 2nd down. Western Kentucky comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Heading for the corner. The 10. Brought down at the 4.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
First down. Defense trying to hold their ground here. It's 1st and goal inside the 5.
Omaha! Omaha!
And they push him out around the 1-yard line. And we reach the end of 3, and this game is all but decided. The Hilltoppers with a huge lead. Second down and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Here's the tailback. Touchdown.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away.
Miller back to return.
It's fielded at the 2. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. They coughed up the pigskin the last time they had the ball. Let's see if they can hold on to it this time.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Now he's scrambling. He can run. And he dives, and he's down. Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. And he's level at the 45. That's a 7-yard gain.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
Let's go.
Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
An update on the game at University Park. This is a game we've been watching closely today. And for Ohio State, a very lethargic performance so far. If they don't watch out, they're going to be in a world of hurt. The Nittany Lions are on top, 24-21.
I don't expect that that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They'll bring him down around the 45-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. Baldwin is the punter. He fields the punt at the 16. He's tackled at the 16. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Western Kentucky with a commanding lead. Gain as he works the right side.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets it on the pitch. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 33.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 33. Pitch right. And down he goes at the 41-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That brings up second and 1.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. At midfield. He's pushed out of bounds at the 40. From the 40-yard line, it's first down. Western Kentucky comes to the line in complete control in this game. Inside give. And he's tackled at about the 11. From the 11-yard line, first down. Takes the ball inside. Tackle right around the 2-yard line. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9.
That brings up second and 1.
It's It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he has it on the corner. Touchdown, Western Kentucky. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He hits a booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Gets rid of it quickly.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one.
Wow, that was close. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's taken down right around the 40.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and 10.
They're changing the play. Powers, back to pass. He's scrambling. And for Martin, here's another addition to a career full of sacks.
They'll be sure to bring him up in the conversation about the most dominant defenders in school history. He's earned his spot here.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. They make the stop at the 47-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Tackle made at about the 45.
McDonald makes the tackle at the 45-yard line. First down.
Can't find anyone open. That's a great tackle at the 49.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He heaves it deep. Almost picked off.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He drops back, and he throws right away. And it's intercepted, and who else? It's the freshman safety.
Boy, another interception. You know, you look at this offense and they're making mistakes, but how about the effort and the tenacity from this defense? Even with the big lead, they're not giving up. I think they want to continue to blow this team out.
First and 10. Ball on the 46. Just under three to go in regulation. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
From the 50, second down. Big opening. He's at the 40. He's tackled at the 21. It's first and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line. Brought down to the open field.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
From the 19-yard line, it's second down. Just over a minute left. He fights forward to about the 16.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 35.
From the 16-yard line, third down. He's taken down at about the 21. And he'll be stopped well short of the first down.
You have the lead in the fourth quarter, and it's third and long. Why risk a turnover? Just play it safe and work the clock.
They're already up big, and this could make the lead bigger. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off.
Wilson sets a return.
He kicks a low line drive. He'll take it from the 2. Tackle at the 24.
Kickoff returns 22 yards.
The offense will start at the 24-yard line.
I think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Picked off, and that'll seal it up.
And he hits him hard at the 26. First and 10, ball on the 26-yard line. Western Kentucky up big. The Hilltoppers don't like the looks of things. They're going to take their first time out. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 26. The 25-yard line. Today we saw a game that wasn't even close. Western Kentucky, 66. Louisiana Monroe, nothing. And the Warhawks, nothing. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Boy, Brad, just an absolutely ugly offensive performance. Louisiana Monroe didn't expect to win this football game, but they hoped to at least put a couple drives together and put some points on the board. That didn't happen because they ran into a defense that was completely dominant. Brad, they didn't even stand a chance today.
Take a look at our choice for today's player of the game. He made a big contribution to his team's win. For Western Kentucky, they remain unbeaten. They pick up their fifth win of the season. And for Louisiana Monroe, they fall to 1-4, and they can't be happy with that. For EA Sports, Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.